Well, I just got a knock on the back door and the UPS guy was there, and I have a box. And this box is from my old friend Charlie Richardson of CR High Performance Products. He's kind of well known as a seminal soap designer in Southern California of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. And he sent me a special box here, CR High Performance Products, Fallbrook, California. I haven't got a box from him in probably 20 years. And there's a vintage slope goodie in here. I'm not sure exactly what it is. I have a good hunch. Let's crack open the box and see what's in it. Okay, first item, official CR sticker. I still have a couple of these, but this is definitely a vintage CR aircraft sticker from back in the day. Pretty cool. What's this weird looking tail thing in here? Wow. What is that thing? It kind of looks like a Savage or some sort of weird turbo. It's got a full flying tail here. Definitely winger on. All wood body. It's got servos in there. Futaba. And Aerotronics. Looks like a prototype of some sort. Man, I have no idea what this is. It's like kind of a cross between Charlie's old Savaron and a Turbo ST with a full flying stab on it. Yeah, kind of interesting. Definitely a lot of spider poop, little dots all over this thing. He says it's been in the rafters for a really, really long time. So looks like it needs a hatch. Let's see what else is in here. There's a turbo in here somewhere. It's well packed. That's for, oh, another CR sticker. Pretty cool. Those are extremely rare. Oh, look at this. A turbo, and this looks like a Turbo S. This is the 50-inch version winger-on plane, all wood, and it looks like it's been in storage for quite a long time too. It's got a wing rod in there. It's got the cool linkages. These are the classic CR linkages. These are handmade by Charlie. What kind of servos in there? It looks like a 94102 standard servo for the wings. Okay. No elevator servo, no hatch. Definitely a class wood, slab sided. It's basically balsa. It has a 1/64 ply on the sides here for strength. This one has not been glassed, and it's pretty light. It's got a number on it, 52. Charlie says that this may have been one of his dad's old airplanes. So this is probably built in the early 90s sometime. That's my guess. There should be some wings here. Yeah, so here's a set of wings for that turbo I just pulled out of the box. Shrink wrapped, like I say, he said he's been in the rafters since the 90s probably. I'm not going to unwrap these now, but looks like they're really nice shape. Looks like it's got some monocoat transparent green on them. These are white styrofoam cores with sheeted with balsa. I think there's some carbon strips in there too, and then vacuum bagged. Got the drive pins. Looks like it's missing one of the drive pins. That's easy to fix. These are pretty light. I'd say this wing set weighs about 5, maybe 6 ounces. So the turbos were definitely great in light slope conditions at Torrey. I think that's about it. I don't see anything else in here. Yep, that's it. So it's going to be a bit of a restoration project here. I'm gonna have to make a hatch. That's super easy. I actually built probably 10 or 12 of these, and I used to help Charlie build these too in the shop at one point too, and XLs as well. And it looks in pretty good shape. I'll probably strip it down and actually maybe put some glass on it. Put some modern radio gear in here. We'll put 2.4 gear in here. Probably some MKS HV, some 6100s here for the wings and the elevator. Those would be absolutely fine. Run those in high voltage mode. This thing would be super fast and twitchy. Tail's looking really good shape. This thing is completely box stock, as I can tell. Well, I actually found the other wing locating pin jammed into the linkages inside here. So I was able to pull that out. It was rusted to the linkages, pulled it out, stuck it in the wing. And we can sort of bench fly this thing. This is what a Turbo S looks like, minus the hatch. Hatch will be an easy build. It's pretty cool. This is really the first high performance glider that I ever flew. I started with a Kyosha Melody 1500, which was a terrible trainer. It was heavy and really difficult to tune up. And then I got a Wanderer, kind of learned on that. And then I got a Turbo S as my first, you know, performance slope airplane. And this thing really taught me how to fly at Torrey Pines and all the other small cliffs around North County, San Diego. So thanks again, Charlie. Someday this will be a cool Turbo S fully restored. Thanks. To listen to a 1 hour interview with Charlie Richardson on designing gliders and how he started the very successful CR High Performance Models, go to my website at radiocarbonart.com and click on the videos and podcast tab. You'll find the interview video at the very top of the featured videos list. Just click the YouTube play button to watch and listen to this fascinating interview with one of the legends of slope soaring.